In the previous class, we discussed about three methods followed for lateral development. Okay, one is parallel line develop method, another will be radial line method, and another method is triangulation. Okay, parallel line development is used for prisms and cylinder. Okay, so this is the cylinder and this is the prism. So in development, we are developing the lateral surface of the solid. Okay, so lateral surface means, so this one. Okay, so other than this, there are two more lateral surfaces. Okay, so before going to the actual problem, okay, so are you able to see the screen? Screen kind of sir, yeah. Okay,
no, sir.
Are you able to see the solid?
Sir,
ಸೊ ಇವಾಗ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಹಾ, ಓಕೆ, ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದಿ ಸಾಲಿಡ್? ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣ್ತಿರೋ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ಯಾವುದು?
ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್.
ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್, ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್? ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ? So does the square prism have an axis? Axis iruta prism ge?
Sir.
Okay, so next, how will it, how will you define axis of a prism? How will you define it? Yavriti define martira axis of a prism? Ha, heli.
The line passing through the center.
Center, yav center? Okay, so now, so carefully observe. In order to understand development of lateral surfaces, first you should know how to describe a solid. Okay, what are the details there in a solid? Okay, so the solid that you can see here is, this is the square prism. Okay, so it consists of two end faces. This is top end face and this is the bottom end face. Since the end faces are having square lamina or square shape, it is called as square prism. Instead of square, if these two end surfaces are having triangle, then this prism is called as triangular prism. Okay, suppose if it is having pentagon, then pentagonal prism. If it is having hexagon on these two end faces, then it is a hexagonal prism. Okay, so this is a square prism. Then, so this is base and this is the top end face. So these two are called as end faces. So then what do you call this face, these four faces, this one and this? So ee faces gen anta karithira? What do you call this face? This one. Can the karitira?
Lateral faces.
Lateral.
This is called as lateral face. Okay. Then what do you call this edge? This line. Really. Lateral edge. Okay. So then what do you call this edge? ಹೇಳಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಡು ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಡ್ಜ್? So this is edge of the top end surface. Okay, or you can call it as shorter edge, and this is the longer edge. Okay, or it is also known as lateral edge. Okay, so this is called as edge of the end face. Okay, this is the top end face, and this is edge or side of the top end face. Okay, so what do you call this edge? It is known as karitira.
Bottom end.
Base edge. Okay, base edge. That means edge of the base. So on the base we have square. So how many base edges are there in this prism? This is one edge, one base edge. Second base, third base edge, fourth. Okay, so totally there are four base edges. How many lateral edges? In a square prism, how many lateral edges you can find? So there are four lateral edges. So this is one edge, this is second, this is third, okay, and this is the fourth one. So now, so we define axis as an imaginary line passing through center of end faces. Okay, this is the base surface, this is the top end surface. An imaginary line passing through center of these two end faces is called as axis. Okay, and the edges of the base are called as base edges. The edges of the lateral surfaces are called as lateral edges or longer edges. Okay, so this is the edges of the top end surface or top end face. Okay, and it is also known as shorter edge. Okay, this is about the prism. So this solid is called as prism. The reason is, so all prisms will have two similar parallel end faces. So that means at the bottom, if we are having square, at the top end face also we will be having a square. At the bottom, if it is pentagon, okay, at the top also we will be having pentagon. Okay, and prism, the shape of the lateral surfaces of the prism is which shape? Rectangular. Okay, so all lateral faces are rectangular. Okay, so these are the features of a prism. So now, so you have to visualize this prism in different orientations. Okay, so this is the front view of the prism. So that means, so when the prism is kept in this orientation, so that means, so if you look from top, so like this, so you are keeping prism such that, so these lateral faces are making an angle 45 degree with the vertical plane. Okay, so the position of the prism is vertical. So now you can see it is vertical. Since the axis of the prism is vertical, the orientation of the prism is vertical. So horizontal orientation means, instead of keeping this prism like that, so if you keep like this, so this is the horizontal. So we kept the prism horizontal. So that means the axis of the prism is horizontal. Keeping a prism vertical means like this. So this is vertical orientation and this is horizontal orientation. Okay, so in horizontal orientation, axis will be horizontal. In vertical orientation, axis will be vertical. Okay, next. So if you look from front, how does it appear? So in front view, so how does this prism look like? It look like a rectangle. Okay, so now you can observe. In front view, it look like a rectangle with three edges. Again, it depends on the orientation. Okay, so now I will try to draw a new prism. Okay, so you can see. So if you want to have a prism in this orientation, Okay. So now I have drawn a prism having base edge length 30 mm. Okay, the length of these edges, base edges is 30 mm, and the height of the prism is 60. Here you can see it is 60. Okay. So this is the square prism. Now, if you look it for look, cut this from front, so it looks like a rectangle. So here, in front view, if the orientation of the prism is such that two lateral surfaces, okay, this is one lateral surface and backside another lateral surface. These two lateral surfaces are parallel to VP, vertical plane, and remaining two lateral surfaces are perpendicular to VP. Okay, so if the orientation of the prism is such that square prism is such that two lateral surfaces are parallel to VP and two lateral surfaces are perpendicular to it, then in front view, so it will look like a rectangle like this. Okay. And in top view, it will look like a square, like this. This is the top view of the prism. If you go to top, that means, so if you try to visualize this solid from top, so from top, if you go and if you look at it, you are able to see it as a square. Okay, from front, if you look at it, again, we are following orthogonal projection. Okay, so you know, what do you mean by orthogonal projection and all those fundamentals, you know? Okay. If you look from front, it looks like a rectangle. So this is the front view. Okay. So if you look from top, so it looks like a square. So now, so from top, you are able to see the top end face. Are you able to see the bottom end face? So new top in the node, are you able to see this face? Can't set either.
No.
So that means in top view, you are able to see the top end face. Remaining all details are invisible. Okay, so this will overlap with this in top view. Okay. So only you are able to see the top end face. So next, from front, how many lateral faces are you able to see? Munda inda nodidre nimge eshtu lateral face kanutte? So you are able to see only one lateral face. So that is nearer to you, nearer to the observer. So but how many lateral face in this prism? There are four. Okay, but you are able to see only one. So this is the front view. Okay, and this is the top view. So this is in case where two lateral faces are parallel to VP and two lateral faces are perpendicular to it. Okay, so at this condition, so you are able to see details like what we discussed. Okay. So next, so this is another case where lateral faces are inclined at 45 degree to VP. Okay. If you can visualize a vertical plane, this is the vertical plane. This are making an angle of 45 degree with VP. Okay. So now, from front, how many lateral faces are you able to see? So, you have to see the lateral faces.
Three.
Lateral faces, not edges. Edges are faces.
Two.
Okay. So, this is one lateral face and this is another lateral face. You are able to visualize two lateral faces. Okay. Next, if you look at this prism from top, how does it look like? So you mele ina nodidre yav riti kanutte idu? ಹಾ ಹೇಳಿ. ಸೊ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೇಶನ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿಜುವಲೈಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ವ್ಯೂ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಟಾಪ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ವ್ಯೂ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಇನ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಓರಿಯೆಂಟೇಶನ್ ಸಚ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ 45 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ವಿಪಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಆ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಇನ್ ಟಾಪ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಸೊ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ವಿತ್ ಆಲ್ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೈನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 45 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ವಿಪಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಡೂ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿ ಡೌಟ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್? ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೂ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಲೈನ್ ದಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಎಡ್ಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫೇಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಎಡ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಎಡ್ಜಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಟಾಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಲೈನ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟಾಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಯು ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದಿ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ? ಪಿಪಿಟಿ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಟಾಪಿಕ್. ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಸೊ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಒನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಪ್ಯಾರಲ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಲಿಂಡರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಟಾಪ್ ಎಂಡ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ನ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫೇಸಸ್, ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್, ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್? ಇದು ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್?
ಪೆಂಟಾಗನಲ್
ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಎ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್?
ಫೈವ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಫೇಸಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ?
ಫೋರ್.
ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಗನಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್?
ಸಿಕ್ಸ್.
ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಕ್ಟಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್?
ಫೋರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದೇ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನಲ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಈ ಪೆಂಟಾಗನ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಕಾಣಿಸಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೊ ಅಗೇನ್ ದಿ ಹೈಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಯರ್ ಟು ಇಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೈಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬೇಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಬೇಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಬೇಸ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಹೈಟ್ ಎಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಬುಕ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್. ಸೊ ನೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ, ಬರ್ಕೊಳಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ ಇವಾಗ? ಹಾಂ, ಸೊ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ಶೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೇಪರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನೋಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್? Okay. So you have to take heading as parallel line development. So next, note down, it is used for prisms and cylinders. So take heading as parallel line development. Then note down, it is used for prisms and cylinders. Okay, after that, note down this problem. A vertical square prism, 30 mm sides, 60 mm height, I, having one of its rectangular faces leaning to the right at an angle of 45 degree to VP, is cut by a cutting plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 60 degree to its axis. The cutting plane passes through the axis at the mid height of the prism. Develop the lower portion of the lateral surfaces of the prism. Okay, so take a sheet of paper or a book and note down this problem. Okay, I will give 2 minutes. You can note down this problem. So otherwise it is not possible for you to follow the concepts. Okay, nim barkalli illa andre nimge kashta agutte follow madodu. Okay, so can I continue madla? Okay, so which is the given solid in this problem? Which is the given solid?
Square prism.
Okay, so what are the details given in the problem? Enen kottidare?
So vertical square prism, 30 mm.
30 mm. 30 mm yavudrudu dimension? 30 mm
vertical.
Okay, so in the problem, so a vertical square prism, so that means given solid is square prism. Vertical square prism means it is kept in vertical orientation. That means axis of the prism will be vertical. So that's why it is called as vertical square prism. So the meaning of vertical square prism is square prism is kept in vertical orientation. Okay. 30 mm sides. 30 mm side means it is the length of the base sides. Okay. So this length is 30 mm. This length, this is 30 mm. These are the sides. Okay, length of the sides, this is 30 mm. Next, height is 60 mm. Height is 60 mm means this height, the length of this lateral edge or the length of the axis. Okay, so it is 60. This length is 60 and this length is 30 mm. Okay, so next, having one of its rectangular faces leaning to the right at an angle of 45 degree to VP. So this is one lateral face, this is another. There are two more lateral faces which we are not able to see in this orientation. Okay, so this square prism is kept in vertical orientation such that this lateral face is making an inclination of 45 degree with VP. Okay, so there will be a vertical plane. So you can consider this as a vertical plane. And this lateral surface is making an angle of 45 degree with this vertical plane. Okay, so this is one possible case. Okay, so in the problem they gave a condition such that we have to keep the prism in vertical orientation and we have to rotate it such that so one of the lateral face will make an inclination of 45 degree with VP. Okay, that means it will be kept like this. Okay, next, so it is cut by a cutting plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 60 degree to its axis. Okay, perpendicular to VP means you have to consider a horizontal plane. Okay, so you have to consider a horizontal plane, so that horizontal plane will be perpendicular to VP. Then you have to rotate that horizontal plane such that it is making an inclination of 60 degree. You have to consider horizontal plane. Okay, it is like chopping. So if you want to chop a cone or any solid, okay, so you ige matta andella elnirella kostar alva, like that you have to chop the solid, you have to do chopping of the solids. Okay, so that is called as cutting plane. So cutting plane is an imaginary plane. Okay, or you can consider so any chopping tool. Okay, so you are using a cutting plane which is perpendicular to VP and making an inclination of 60 degree with HP like this. So ill one plane irutte. Okay, that plane will pass through the solid and it will cut the solid into two pieces. So next, so they have given the condition where you are going to pass this cutting plane. Okay, it will be passed at the center. Okay, the cutting plane passes through the axis at the mid height of the prism. Mid height means, so what is the height of this prism? What is the height?
60 millimeter.
60. Mid height means how much?
30
millimeter.
30. Okay. So now you are considering midpoint of this vertical line at a height 30. Okay. So the cutting plane has to pass through this point and the orientation of the cutting plane is, it is making an angle of 60 degree with VP like this. Its orientation will be like this. So you are going to pass a cutting plane here. Okay, so that means the solid will be cut into two parts, so above portion and below portion. So which part we need to develop? ನಮಗೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ದಿ ಲೋಯರ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪಾಸ್ ಎ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಸಚ್ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಮಿಡ್ ಹೈಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 60 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ವಿತ್ ಎಚ್ ಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೆವಲಪಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಲೋಯರ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್, the above portion we are going to remove it. We are not considering the above portion, we are considering only the lower half and we are going to develop it. Okay, so this is about the given problem. A vertical square prism, 30 mm sides, 60 mm high, having one of its rectangular face leaning to right at an angle of 45 degree to VP, is cut by a cutting plane perpendicular to VP and inclined at 60 degree to its axis. The cutting plane passes through the axis at the mid height of the prism. Develop the lower portion of the lateral surfaces of the prism. Okay, so if you look from front, okay, how does the front view look like? Front view yena kanutta idu this prism, it will look like a rectangle. Okay, in top view it look like a square. Okay, next you can follow a procedure. Okay, so where, so the solution for this problem will be drawn step by step. Okay, I am going to explain that. Okay, wait for 1 minute. Okay, so are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you got line draw maadi kaanustha nimge. So are you able to see this line?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so initially, so you have to draw the XY line. Okay, now I am drawing XY line. Okay. So next, vertical plane and horizontal plane. Okay. So where does the front view lie? Front view of a solid lie. Where HP. It will be projected? Front view. Front view, L project Martira.
VP.
VP, vertical plane. Top view?
HP.
HP. Okay. So square prism do top view yav riti kanutte?
Rectangle.
Top view. Melinda nodidre en kanutte? Vertical ag square idittaga. Square. Okay. Front inda nodidaga?
Rectangle.
Okay. So now I am going to draw its top view. Okay. That means it will look like a square making an inclination of 45 degree with VP. Okay. So I will draw that. Okay, why I am drawing the square in this orientation? What is the reason? Okay, instead of drawing like this, why I am drawing like this?
So lattice.
So one of the lateral surface is making an angle of 45 degree with VP. Okay, so they have given the inclination. So one of the lateral surface. This line represents lateral surface of a prism in top view. This is another lateral surface. This is also lateral surface. This is also a lateral surface in top view. Okay. So in the problem, they gave a condition such that it is making an inclination of 45 degree with VP. So that's why I have drawn in this orientation. Okay. Next, I have to name the points. Okay. So I am dimensioning it. So they have given the length of the side as 30. 30 mm. Okay, next I so go on naming the points. Okay. So here, why I have named it as A and inside the bracket A1. What is the reason? What does this A1 represent? Really? Really? So one of you try to answer. So if you look from top, okay, only top end face is visible, bottom end face is invisible. So top end face is denoted by ABCD. Base, that is bottom end face, is denoted by A1, B1, C1, D1. Bottom end face is invisible, andre kaansalla, bottom end kaansalla, top face kaanutte. That's why ABCD outside the bracket. Kaansadna bracket illalle barithive. So the details which are invisible, invisible details are represented inside the brackets. Okay. So A1, B1, C1, D1 represents bottom end face of the prism, which is invisible from top. If you look from top, only the top end face will be visible, whereas bottom end face is invisible. Okay. This O1 represents axis of the prism. So this is the center of top face. O1 is the center of bottom face. Okay. This is about the top view. Next, so I will project the lines. Okay, so these are the projectors, projection lines. Okay. Next, I will draw the front view. Okay, like this. So height of the prism is given, that is
60 mm.
Okay, I am also considering the mid height, so that is at 30 mm, in order to pass the cutting plane. Okay, so this is the representation of a cutting plane. So in the problem, they gave a condition, cutting plane should pass at mid height. So this is the mid height, and this should be inclined at 60 degree to HP. Okay, so this is inclined at 60 degree to HP. So this is the representation of the cutting plane. Okay, 60 degree to axis. So this is the axis, and it is making an angle of 60 degree with the axis. Okay. So in the problem, so they gave to develop only the lower portion. So that means the portion that is highlighted here, so this will be developed. Whereas the top of portion, so this portion will be removed. So after passing cutting plane, so this portion so will be removed. So that's why we are not considering this, and this is represented with thin lines. Okay, next. So we are developing. So that means we are going to unfold this prism. If we unfold it, we are going to get 4 strips. So that means 4 lateral faces like this. Initially, we will get the development of complete prism. So then we make use of the points on the cutting plane, and we are going to get the final required development. Okay, so here, so we are going to do development. So by considering A1, okay, this is the point from where we are going to do unfolding. So we are going to unfold it, and we are going to make it as a plane sheet. Okay, so then, so this will be having 30, then 60, 90, and 120. So total length will be, our total width will be 120. So that means width of this is 30, and from year to year it is 30, year to year it is 30, 30. So totally it will be 120, where each side edge will be having a length of 30, 30, 30, 30, and 30. Okay. So next, so I am naming the points. So in development, in order to name the points, we use uppercase, that is capital letters. So base is denoted by A1, B1, C1, D1. So in development, it is indicated as capital A1, capital B1, capital C1, and capital D1. So again, it will end with A. So this is the unfolding point. So the unfolding edge. So we'll begin with A and end with the same point, unfolding. Okay. So we'll unfold madidre. So left matte right edge kadegu aa edge move aguthe. So that's why you are getting A for two lines. The reason is when you unfold it, so it will be distributed to two edges. So one lateral edge will be distributed to two edges. Again, if you join, it will become one. Okay, so this method is called as parallel line method. The reason is, so after passing a cutting plane, you are going to consider the points where the cutting plane pass through the lateral edges. So this is the cutting plane. So here it is passing through the lateral edge A1. Here it is passing through the lateral edge B1. Again, here it is passing through the lateral edge C1. And here they have also considered 4. The reason is, so the lateral edge B1 and D1 are overlapping with one another. So D1 is present in the back side that we are not able to see from front. So ಮುಂದೆಯಿಂದ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ D1. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ 4 ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಎಡ್ D1. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪೋಲ್. Okay, I have created a poll, so you have to answer for your attendance.
Yes, sir.
Bandidya?
Close agide.
Close agide. Okay. Once again, na namel create martini at the end of the class. So I will create another poll. Okay. Don't worry if you have not answered. Don't worry. I'll create another poll later. Okay, so this method is called as parallel line method. The reason is, so this is the point you got. From this point, you are drawing a line which is horizontal. So this is one horizontal line, and this is another horizontal line, and this is another horizontal line. So all these lines are parallel to one another. So you are extending the lines such that they are parallel to one another. So when you pass a cutting plane, So you are going to get points where cutting plane is going to pass through the lateral edge. So that is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Then, so you are drawing horizontal lines from 1, such that, so it will meet this. It will pass through AA. Okay, this is, 1 is the point on a lateral edge AA1. So you have to draw a horizontal line such that it will pass through AA and AA. So AA1 here. Here also AA1. Next, from 2, you are drawing it till it pass through BB1. And again 4 also this point. So DD1. Then 3, you are passing it till CC1. So 3 is the point where cutting plane is passing through the lateral edge CC1. Okay. So after locating these points, so then you are going to combine them like this. So you are going to draw, this is the base. So this is the lateral edge, okay, and you are connecting 1 to 2, 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, then again 4 to 1, and this, and then remaining lateral edges. Okay, so this is the development. This is the final solution for the given problem. So ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ನಾವು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಸಾಲಿಡ್, ಆ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ ದು ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ನ ಮಾತ್ರ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದ್ರ ಸರ್ಫೇಸಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಶೀಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಶೀಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ರೆಕ್ಟಾಂಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಶೀಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬರೀ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ನ ನಾವು ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಅನ್ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಸ್, ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ನ ನಾವು ಸ್ಲೈಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಪೀಸಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಿಸಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು 2 ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ಟಾಪ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾವು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರೋದು ಬರೀ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಮಾತ್ರ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಲೋ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ಬಾಟಮ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ, ಇನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದಟ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ ಫಾಲೋಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ.